on this episode of Crappie Kings Television.
And here I am in the heartland of USA, going to fish on Wren Lake with Kyle Schoonhire.
Oh, what's that?
Ooh,
nice slab.
Little roadrunner.
Meep, meep.
When I'm fishing shallow water, muddy water, heavy cover, I like a roadrunner just for the vibration, the flash.
Ooh, yep. He was hung way down in there.
He stuck way inside there. Easy down, easy up. Much easier said than done.
Like I said, the size of these fish is bigger than I've seen ever since I was a kid. It's amazing how many little fish will cram in one little area. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
There you go.
There he is.
There we go.
Oh, attaboy. Look how dark that fish is, eh?
There's a good little male.
Attaboy.
Again, we don't just stop at one layer. We're going to keep going. And that's what everybody comes for.
I'm Carl Kalonka, and this is my job. Traveling across North America in search of the best crappie holes while hooking up with some legendary crappie fishermen and a host of colorful characters along the way. Visiting some distinctive destinations and having opportunity to sample some very unique culinary cuisine.
Uh-oh, I hear some splashing.
Where's that little one that popped me before? There it is. My first crappie in the bushes. Big, eh? You're just little, but you're fun, because you are in this stuff right there. This nasty cover. Flooded timber, brush, buck brush, whatever you want to call it. The crappie are in it, we're in it, we're going to have a blast. Getting in here, hopefully the rain stays away where we can get in and have some fun. And catch some of these fish and maybe get some nice big black ones or white ones and in full spawning color. Have a meal, have some fun. Let's keep going. This guy knows his stuff. Everybody knows him. He wins all these tournaments. He guides full time. I'm looking forward to catching a whole bunch of crappie in the bushes.
Oh, what's that?
Ooh.
Nice slab. Nice one, man.
There's a little female.
You said first drop.
Yeah, we called that, didn't we?
Yeah. Good one, Kyle.
Another little eater. You know, this winter I talked to Carl and invited him to come down and fish the bushes. And it's normally real predictable in May this time of year, but for this year, whatever reason, it wasn't that predictable.
Oh, there's one right there.
Look where he's coming out of. That is wild, man.
Right my pole.
Decent little fish too, isn't he here?
Yeah, he's a little eater. He's probably about 10 inches.
Nice.
I think this might be a little male that moved up and ain't been in too long. I think he is. Nice little white.
Yeah, man. Let's put him in the hurt locker.
Yeah.
See, you can tell who the guide's here, eh? Right away. Boing! Got one, huh? A little roadrunner. Look at that thing. Huh? A little chartreuse. Black and green. A little blade on there. Just falls through that heavy stuff. They see it. They're eating it. But the fun is fishing in this stuff. We're not expecting any monster crappie, but just fun. Eaters, got some nice ones, but it's the way we're fishing in this nasty stuff. You got to do it to get them. Hopefully get some good ones too. So now he tells me we're going to fish the bushes. I'm thinking we're going to go to the edges of them, 10-foot rods, shake on the edge, maybe put the rod in a bit, you know, they're 10 feet long, right inside the bush and shake. I had no idea he's going right inside the bushes. This is cool, man. I'd never done this before for crappie. I can tell you it's the first time, but it ain't gonna be my last. This is a blast. I can only imagine getting a good one in here. Pounder, boy. You gotta put it in slow, bring it out slow. You know, even though it's real heavy cover and we're using braid, you gotta be more, you know, finesse-like. Shake it down inside the branches. The fish are in there, but you just can't try to bulldoze your bait in or out. You just get frustrated. What's a big fish for this lake, Kyle?
2 pounds.
No
kidding. 2 pounds is going to be a big fish. And but over the last 3 years, I've seen more fish at that mark than I ever have in my life.
Wow.
It's the size has really come up in this lake. A lot more pound and a quarter to pound and a half fish than there ever has been before.
That's nice. And you got the small ones too, so you know the reproduction's
good. Right, yeah. Yeah, there's so much good habitat for these fish to spawn in this lake that pretty much every year is a successful spawn.
Good.
Boy, he is a pretty little guy.
Yep. All black.
Yeah, we pulled up to the first bush, catching a few fish, realized that we're not catching the size of fish that, you know, I normally get out of there. You know, I'm starting to realize that this cold front's making a lot more challenging for us today.
Uh-oh. There's a little female.
A little crappie. Cal's a good teacher, eh? Oh, this is cool, man. I just put it in there too, you know what, with nothing. And I put it probably maybe, like you said, about a foot away from where I put it in before.
Yep.
Paid attention where the hook, where the dropped it. And look what's there. He's not big, but he's there. He could have been big, but the key to this is putting it in, having patience, and just keep dropping it in, like flipping and pitching the jig over and over and over. The walleye, trout, anything. This is all persistence. I say it all the time. Just keep going. Check the point. Oh, nice and sharp. Little roadrunner. Meep, meep. The crappie's after you, roadrunner. That's probably a trademark. I'll probably get sued now. Right? Cease and desist. I said, we're over. All done. See you next week, Looney Tune. Finally, start getting some crappie. The confidence builds. There's nothing like getting that first fish in the boat to give you the confidence and the focus to start whooping crappie butt.
There we go.
Oh, attaboy. Look at how dark that fish is, eh?
There's a good little male.
Attaboy.
Mm. Another nice 10 one. Inch. It's a good eating size male.
Oh yeah, look at the fins.
That one's got pretty color on.
Yeah, beautiful. Bright and heavy, thick stuff.
Boy, he was way back in there too.
Heavy cover crappie, I'd say. Eating size?
Yeah, that's sure. A good eater right there.
Good stuff, man. Let's do it.
Another one for dinner. Every once in a while, you'll pick up a female just hanging out on the edge of the stuff. But most of the time, males and females both, especially males, will be way up right in the thickest little hole
gotcha.
That you can see.
Okay.
Try them in on a cork in there too. Ooh. Before we leave.
That is some nasty stuff in there.
There we go. Found us see a little hole there.
See how you do it, folks? Right there.
He ain't big, but he's still about 10-inch fish.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
It's a pretty little fish.
Yep. Nice one, man.
Carl, two out of one hole.
Yes.
Getting somewhere now.
Yeah.
Gotta be a old big one in there.
Like that? I don't miss the talent, eh?
See how this one's a little darker? See how he's more? See, he's getting a little bit darker here. So this little guy's been up here a little bit longer. He's a little guy. We'd probably let him back. Right in that little hole, right?
Now, I fish a lot of years, a lot of different techniques, presentations, and locations, but this was as intense as it gets. And Kyle, right away, bang, 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 fish. Like I'm standing there, it looks like I don't even know what I'm doing.
Ready? Here we go. I'm in. Wow, is that a hard bite I had, man?
Yeah, that one. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
There you go. There you go.
There he is.
That's what we're after. Well,
he fell off in the boat. That's where he should fall off.
Eh? That's right.
Wow. That's what you get right there. Kyle knows his stuff. And these bushes, I'm telling you, if you want to experience sometime in your life catching crappie and this kind of stuff, you won't forget it, man, because I sure won't. I'm having a blast.
Hi, my name is Gina Atchison. I'm the GM of Rend Lake Resort and Conference Center on beautiful Rend Lake in Winnington, Illinois. Behind us, we have our conference center, which was developed in 2002. It houses 48 rooms and 300-person conference center. On top of that, here at the resort, we also have 22 cabins, 20 boatel units, which are located right on Rend Lake. We also have boat rentals at our gift shop. This is home to a lot of different crappie tournaments, bass tournaments. Come down for the weekend, hunt, fish, golf, shoot, just come down and enjoy the local attractions. You can reach us by calling 1-800-633-3341 or going to our website, www.rendlakeresort.com. Come on down and see us. We'll treat you just like family.
Yeah, there's a lot of jigs out there that you can use for spawning crappie. But when I'm fishing shallow water, muddy water, heavy cover, I like a Roadrunner just for the vibration, the flash. There's so many scenarios that you can go through to get these fish to bite, and the Roadrunner covers all of them. So it's one of my real go-to baits anytime I'm fishing shallow, muddy water.
Oh, hello, man. Beautiful fish. Nice dark fish.
Yeah, them are pretty. Pretty as can be. Yeah, that fish hit it just about an inch under the water.
Wow. Catch and release.
Yeah,
folks.
That wasn't an inch or two under the water. He popped it.
Huh.
Ooh.
Okay, how many times is that going to happen? Seriously. That's like four in a row. What am I?
That's a little bit better.
Yeah, man. Nice one. Okay, I'll put the exact same spot right there.
That one we better hang on to.
Who knows how many are in there?
Yeah.
Huh? Who knows? What if the last one's just a big pig?
That might be, too. That one hit it like he had a little weight.
Look at the size of the Roadrunner minnow right there. Is that the one that's going to do it? Let's see. Old Kyle's in the spot. I'm in. I need to be right in that little hole, right about there.
Uh-oh, you got it that time.
What do you say, mamacita? You think you're going to take every one of my baits? Not every one. Man, up through the nose, too.
That's when they're hooked good.
Yeah. Like, man. Little fat belly crappie. It's cool when you set. They hardly move. They got any size at all, unless they're little munchkins, yeah. You just stay down, and you're like, oh, how big? And then they thrash. Then you see them. A lot of fun.
Yeah.
A lot of fun. What was that, like five or six of one thing?
Yeah.
Son of a gun.
That's the way it ought to be.
Oh, ooh. Yeah. Look at that.
Oh,
he's stuck.
Me.
He's stuck.
There we go.
Oh, he's in the boat. Nice one, Kyle.
There's a good female.
Nice fish. Nice fish. Man, folks, welcome to Kyle's clinic.
Yeah, that's a good little female there.
Easy down, easy up. Much easier said than done. Because every time that little hook finds a branch, a twig, a stick, anything, it gets caught up. You gotta fish with patience and focus. That's how you're gonna catch these crappie.
These are some good looking bushes on
fish the same way you'd fish any other way.
To me, this bush right here is where they should all be at. Right, this big bush all by themselves.
Yeah.
All by itself. Oh, there you go. Ooh, that's a good one too.
Uh-oh.
Ooh, get him coming.
Uh-oh.
We'll have to get the hook. Is he stuck?
Yeah, he's stuck. Look at that, folks. There he is. Here
it's
he comes.
A good female, too.
Use the hook. She's stuck.
Get right in.
And there she is. How's that for teamwork? Hey? Look how deep she took that, Kyle.
There you go.
Look at that. Look where my minnow is. Look where my bait is. Look down there. Hey? Look at that, man.
Yeah.
Hey? Did she mean it or what? There's no way I was going to miss that bite. It was like this.
Yeah.
Wow. The man put us on him. Beautiful. Let's put her in a box. Keep going. Catch some more. This is fun, I'm telling you. It doesn't matter what way you fish for crappie, spider rig, fishing brush piles, dragging, jigging, side trolling, everything else. But this stuff is just another way to find them and catch them. Glory be, finally got a big fish. Phenomenal. He gets stuck, he's gotta get a Captain Hook, grab the fish. Meanwhile, I'm holding the fish in the bushes. You talk about excitement. Now this is what it's all about.
Ooh, there crappie. We go.
That's what it was, a good one too.
Yeah, he was shaking that limb. We've seen him shaking that limb over there.
Wow.
Just a little bit bigger.
Yeah. Awesome, man. Now look at the color of that one.
Oh yeah, they're just nice male. And they're not too colored up yet, so they're just a lot of these fish are just getting moving in.
Yeah, man.
Last 3 days we went from water temps to 50, upper 50s and now it's in the mid 60s, so that's a good sign.
Yeah.
You can tell he ain't been in here too long or he'd be jet black all down.
Beautiful
fish.
That's
a good one there.
Yeah, good stuff, Kyle.
One trick that we do here in the spring when we're going after especially male crappie is tipping your jig with live bait, usually a minnow or what I've been using is a wax worm. Because a male's not necessarily want to eat that bait, he's just trying to protect that area and really just kind of kill it. Something about the scent of a wax worm really, really deters them and it'll put a lot more fish in your boat.
Now you talk about intense. This guy, he's not guiding for crappie. He's practicing for tournaments, fishing tournaments. It's crappie 12 months of the year, and it shows because he really knows his stuff.
Yeah, what we're doing here, this is a must-have tool in the bushes. It's made by Blake Moore. It's called Brush Gripper. Just made for just exactly this. When you find a little spot that you caught a few fish, instead of running your troll motor and moving up and down, back and forth, you just hook on there, you know, you're stationary, and now we can fish and not worry about the boat moving. So it's a must-have deal for cool. Stuff like this.
It's catching time in the bushes.
There we go.
Another one. Oh boy, Kyle's on fire, folks. He's on fire. He's serious about this now.
Another little 10-incher for dinner.
Fishing with Carl and the camera guy, they're a pleasure to be around. Had an awesome time filming the show. The weather really spared us, worked out really great, got a good show, caught some fish, had a lot of fun. Can't wait for next time till them big fish get in the bushes.
Kamikaze fishing. Have you done this before? Now I say I did it. You said it was intense crappie fishing, and it is.
That is for sure.
High impact, one-on-one. You know, there's one thing about being in the heartland. There's never a shortage of somewhere good to eat. And here at Red Lake Resort, at Riley's, you might go in hungry, but I guarantee you will not leave that way. Let's go see what he's got on the menu. Is it gonna be catfish, crappie, burgers, or something real special?
Hi, I'm Andrew Atchison, executive chef at Red Lake Resort. Today we're going to show you how to make our famous club sandwich. We got some fresh, fancy white bread, lightly buttered. We're going to grill it fresh every time. A lot of club sandwiches have lettuce, tomato, bacon, everyday stuff on them. Just come in a couple levels. Not here. We're going big. Everything's cut fresh. We've got everything ready for us here. We've got ham, two kinds of cheese. We've got American and cheddar cheese. We've got fresh tomatoes, six slices of bacon, two pieces of lettuce, fresh turkey. We're gonna go ahead and pre-build everything here. We're gonna take us a layer of ham, layer of lettuce. Don't ever want our bread to get soggy, so we're gonna layer everything on top of our dry stuff so nothing gets the bread wet. Ham, tomatoes, bacon. We're gonna go for our second layer here. We've got a good half a pound of turkey, a couple of more tomatoes, got a couple more pieces of bacon. Each one of those layers is gonna get its own cheese, cheddar and American. check on our sandwich bread. Nice and grilled. That's gonna go with some fresh chips. Made fresh every day. All right, and we're ready to put the club together. Again, we don't just stop at one layer. We're gonna keep going. That's an everyday club. We're gonna go one better than that. And this is how we do it at Windows. Little stick in it to keep it all together. And that's what everybody comes for.
Ah, the famous Wren Lake Resort Club Sandwich. I'm sure glad we built up an appetite on the lake, because this clubhouse sandwich really is something special.
One fresh club.
Had a great time at Wren Lake. This ain't gonna be my last time, and I'm definitely gonna be back with Kyle next year in the bushes, hopefully with some real big fat slabs.
Give Kyle a call at 618-314-2967 for an awesome crappie adventure. Crappie Kings Television, in association with Arden, Rule the Water, B&M Poles, wherever fishing takes you, Roadrunner Fishing Lures. Visit us at crappiekings.com.